Hello everyone, I am Priya Maurya from Smriti College of Pharmaceutical Education, Indore. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss Unit 5 of Physical Pharmaceutics first. The Unit 5 comprises of pH buffers and isotonic solution. In this particular topic, we will discuss the Sorensen's pH scale, pH determination techniques, that is electrometric or calorimetric technique. Apart from that, we will also discuss the application of buffers, buffer equation, what is buffer capacity, buffers and their use in the pharmaceuticals and biological system, and buffered isotonic solution. So let's discuss one by one. So first is pH. So what is pH? If we talk in chemistry, the pH is a scale which is used to specify the acidity or basicity of an aqueous solution. If we talk about any acidic solution, so acidic solutions with the higher concentration of hydrogen ions, and they have the lower pH values. If we talk about the basic solutions, so the alkaline or basic solution have the higher concentration of the OH negative ions, and they have higher pH values, and the pH scale note the reading in the alkaline region. So this is the definition of pH in chemistry. Apart from that, if we talk about buffers, so buffers are the solution which resists the change in the pH upon addition of small amount of acid or alkaline substances. So buffer are the compounds or mixtures, or the mixture of compounds that they, by their presence in the solution, they resist the change in the pH upon the addition of small quantities of the acid or alkaline substances. So this is the basic introduction about pH and buffers. If we talk about Sorensen's pH scale, which is drawn here, the Sorensen definition of pH as the hydrogen ion concentration. So the original concept of pH was developed by the Soren Peder, Laurent Sorensen, and involved the concentration rather than the activity of the hydrogen ions. This was the result of earlier work by the Arrhenius, whose 1884 definition of an acid was something that dissociates in the solution to produce the hydrogen ions, that denotes the acid. In 1909, a renowned chemist, that is Sorensen, developed the simple pH scale, which measures whether a substance is acidic or basic or alkaline in nature. He also studied the enzymes made from the proteins and quickly realized that hydrogen ion concentration were important to how do these enzymes perform their functions. So he developed the pH scale as a way to keep track of these conditions in a solution. Also, he demonstrated that the term pH means the potential of hydrogen ions, or we can say the potential of hydrogen, and the scale is negative base 10 logarithm of the concentration of positively charged hydrogen in a solution. That means if we talk about the value from 0 to 14, this is the minus logarithm scale. So if we talk about Sorensen's pH scale, so in this particular scale, pH defined by the small p and capital H. So why it's like that? It's like this. So the small p in the pH stand for the potence, which means the power. Since the scale was given by a Danish chemist whose name is Sorensen, and here the particularly H is basically stand for the hydrogen, and the symbol for the hydrogen is capital H. Therefore, the pH denotes by the small p and capital H. So, pH is the potential hydrogen, is an easier way to measure the hydrogen ion concentration in a solution, or how many hydrogen ions are present in a given liter of solution. This is measured by the pH. Sorensen scale assign a pH value from 0 to 14, which begins 1 is the most acidic, or we can say this is the most acidic. Zero stands for battery acid. We can say zero. Here zero denotes the pH of battery acid. If we talk about the Sorensen pH scale, it ranges from 1 to 14. The lower number, that is 1, that denotes the pH of the hydrochloric acid from the stomach lining. The pH scale works in the power of 10. So each jump in number is a multiple of 10 in concentration. For example, a pH less than 7 is acidic. A pH greater than 7 is alkaline or basic. So the pH scale is logarithmic, and hence each whole pH value below 7 is 10 times more acidic than the next higher value. For example, if we talk about 7 and 6, so when we jump from 7 to 6, the pH value is 10 times more in comparison to 6. So if we talk next number, so it will ultimately 100 times more than the particularly 7. So as we move downwards in this particular scale, the pH value ultimately increases the acidity. So the same holds for the pH value above the 7, for example, each of which is 10 times more basic than the next lower value. For example, if we talk about pH value 10, is 10 times more alkaline than the pH value of 9, and 100 times more alkaline than pH 8. So likewise, we move downwards. If we talk in upward direction, so this is 10 times more alkaline from 8, and more 100 times more alkaline from 8 up to 10. So this is about the alkalinity or acidity level of particularly in Sorensen's pH scale. Here are some example. For example, if we see this scale in this particular, 7 number denotes the neutral pH. As we move downwards, the acidity increases. As we move upwards, the alkalinity increases. Here are some examples. For example, if we talk about pH value 1, so hydrochloric acid from the stomach lining having a pH value of 1. If we talk about a common chemical example, that is vinegar having the pH value of approximately 2.9 to 3. If we talk about pH value of pure water, so pure water having pH value of 7. If we talk about urine pH, so urine pH is approximately 6 or 5.8 to 6. If we talk about an alkaline region, so the most alkaline compound is caustic soda, that is having pH value of 14. Apart from that, the bleach is having the pH value ranges from 12 to 13. If we talk about, you heard the name, that is milk of magnesia having the pH value of 10. This is the Sorensen's pH scale. After this, if we talk pH and Sorensen's scale, so the electrolytes which are undergone the dissociation in the water and producing the H positive ions, that will ultimately denotes the pH. Acids undergo ionization in the water, giving the hydrogen ions or hydronium ions. Basically, it is H positive or OH negative. The thermodynamic definition for pH is, the pH is defined as the negative logarithm of acidity of hydrogen ions. Mathematically, it is expressed as pH is equals to minus of log AH positive. That means pH is equals to minus log of AH positive. Here H positive is the hydrogen ion concentration, and A denotes particularly A denotes the activity of the hydronium ions, that is H positive. The activity of the hydronium ion is equals to the hydronium ion concentration multiplied by the rational activity coefficient. So AH positive further denoted by C multiplied by Y, where C is the concentration of the hydronium ion and Y is the rational activity coefficient. Upon substitution, equation 2 from the equation 1, that is equation 1, and H positive, ultimately we will consider the H positive value is equals to C multiplied by Y. So ultimately, so here the pH value ultimately gives you equation, that is pH is equals to minus log of C multiplied by Y. Here we substituted H positive with C multiplied by Y, that is hydronium ion concentration and rational activity coefficient. So for practical purpose, activities are equal to the concentration in diluted solution where salts are not added, because ionic strength is small when natural salts are added. The hydrogen ion's activity is affected and hence activity coefficient should be employed in equation 3, that is denoted by Y. So Sorensen defined the pH as the logarithm of the reciprocal of the hydrogen ion concentration. Mathematically it will expressed as pH is equals to log 1 upon hydronium ion concentration. We will denote hydronium ion concentration likewise. This is the denotation of hydrogen ion concentration. In this particular equation, if we rearrange particular equation, so pH is equals to log 1 minus log of hydronium ion concentration. If we talk about the application part of the pH, so application part of pH is it enhances the solubility. Basically, any chemical compound having different solubility depending on the pH. So sometimes it might happen at acidic pH, the solubility of that particular compound will increase, and it might be possible at alkaline pH the solubility will get increased. So the solubility will ultimately depend upon the pH value of the particular solution. Also, if we talk about buffer, so we already know that the buffers having the capacity to resist the change in pH. So ultimately when we use the buffers in the preparation, it ultimately increases the stability of the particular compounds. After that, the third portion or the third application is, after solubility and stability, the third is improving the purity. Ultimately with the help of the pH, we will improve the purity of any chemical substances. After that, we will optimize the biological activity of many chemical compounds. Apart from that, comforting of body, as we all know that our GIT tract having varying pH from the buccal cavity up to the anus. So here ultimately we adjust the pH value in different parts, like whenever we having the acidity or a higher acidity in stomach, then ultimately we will intake the milk of magnesia to reduce the pH or to reduce the acidity in the stomach. After that, one more application is the storage of product. On storage, the stability is the most concern for the pharmaceutical products. So on storage, ultimately the stability of the compound matters a lot. So that's why stability is the main concern in pharmaceutical products. So these all are the application part of the pH. Thank you.